Please be seated. Good morning and welcome to this service to honour the life of the incredibly loved and cherished Veronique. I am Suzanne O'Keefe. I'd like to take a moment to ask everyone to please check that your mobile phones are turned off out of respect for Veronique, and to take the opportunity in thanking Sean Hamilton and his staff for the love, care and compassion of the family at this very difficult time. It is certainly appreciated. I would also like to extend a very warm welcome to those that are joining from the live stream, and sincerely hope that wherever you may be joining us from, that this service is able to bring you some comfort as well. We extend our deepest sympathy and condolences to Veronique's beloved family. On this beautiful, not so dry morning, let's sit with one another in this time we have together in a spirit of appreciation for Veronique. We meet here today to celebrate the life of Veronique, Rebecca Williams, and to express our love and admiration for her. Veronique's life was lived in all of its uniquenesses, the moments that brought joy, laughter, humour, and wisdom. Veronique was known to those who love her most as Mum, Veronique, Niki, and V. And our thoughts and condolences are particularly with her family, her daughter Nisha, her father Warren and his friend Jill, his sister and brother-in-law Felicity and Tony, his brother and sister-in-law Peter and Anita, his sister Kerry and her friend Warren, her nieces and nephews Matthew, Jai, Jessica, Rainey, Noah, Oliver, Ryan and Bridie, her great-niece Lucy, her best friend Ellie MacDonald, they've been friends since their school days, her dear friend Savis, and her extended family, and her many, many wonderful friends. Today is a day for memories. Today will be remembered for many reasons, but mainly I hope it will be remembered by you all as a very special day, a special day in which you shared some time with others in order to pay your last respects and to say both mentally and physically a sad and fond farewell to a lovely woman, a woman who you were all so very privileged to have known. We have come together from different places and we are all at different stages on our journey through life. Our paths are varied and we look at life in different ways, but there is one thing we all have in common at one point or another, and to some degree, our lives have been touched by the life of Veronique. And so this morning we've put aside our usual activities for a while and gathered here to give expression to the thoughts and feelings that well up in us at this time of loss. And also because in one way or another, Veronique's death affects us all. Grieving is a heart-wrenching time in our lives. No one travels through life without at some point experiencing the loss of someone dear to them. The passing of a loved one is one of life's most difficult challenges, and the pain can be overwhelming. When I met with some of Veronique's family last Tuesday evening, they generously shared with me some things about Veronique. They told me that Veronique would often say, "You do know, I studied contract law, you know." I learnt that Veronique adored her two beautiful Pomeranians, she named after the famous Italian fashion house, Dolice and Gauthier, thank you. And their nicknames, just to make it a bit easier for some, are Dolly and BB. And let me tell you, they are the most gorgeous little dogs. And these two beautiful little dogs adored their mum. Veronique's family also shared with me some of her, who she was. And this is just a little of what they had told me. Veronique had a brilliant sense of humour, very funny and very smart. She was very quick at defining people in their own words and even quicker at assigning them a nickname, often with hilarious results. She was a great storyteller. Her vocabulary was amazing. It was as if she had swallowed the dictionary and thesaurus. She lived for books. She was an avid reader and especially loved Jane Austen novels. When Twilight came out, she read all the novels. She even taught herself to play the Twilight theme on the piano. She loved it that much. She was a perfectionist and she was a planner and would always write meticulously long lists. She didn't like letting people down. In fact, she hated that. She was very good at picking up on people that needed help without making them feel bad. She was very good at knowing where her life was going and didn't have any trouble projecting that. She was always up for an adventure and would bring you along, sometimes reluctantly, for the journey. I could tell you more stories, but I will now hand over to a close confidant, Peter, who loves her very much. Could I please ask Veronique's brother, Peter, to come forward and share some very special memories of his sister with all of us.
Where do you want me? Thank you, Suzanne. That was beautiful. Welcome, everybody. Firstly, I'd like to thank you all for coming today. This is not my idea of family and friends gathering for a memorable occasion, but today is about celebrating the life of someone we all knew. A mother, a daughter, a sister, a cousin, a niece, or just someone you met in your journey through life who caught your attention with her big blue eyes, her cheesy grin, her stunning good looks, and just her infectious personality. Veronique may have cut your hair at some point, curled your eyebrows, or just yatted in your ear for 40 minutes while you decided what it was you wanted doing in a salon. You may have sat beside her at uni, trying to concentrate on what it was the lecturer was rattling on about, but I know Veronique sat beside you today, asking 30 questions every second, correcting the lecturer or challenging the information they are teaching, because bet your last dollar that she is correct. Research and knowledge retention was her superpower. As for that 3,000 word essay, you can guarantee by the end of the lesson, the topic had changed because Veronique had outwitted the lecturer in her own class because she believed the question at hand was simply wrong. This is her. Veronique Rebecca Williams, born 2nd of March 1978 at Tamworth Base Hospital. She's the fourth born to proud parents, Warren and Robin, and a little sister to Felicity, Kerry and myself. Grandparents, William, Elsie, Carl and Frieda. Uncles and aunties include Irene, Coral, Bam, Harry, Dink, Narelle, Ken and Karen. Veronique is now the youngest cousin to Alan, Merle, Graham, Mervyn, Brian, Melissa, Lenny, Vicky, Duncan, Raywin, Tony, Juliet, Cherie, Brett, Lani, Sean, Adam, Matthew and Christopher. Try getting that mob together on Christmas Day for a turkey and gravy roll. Veronique started life living at 7 Nancy Street in South Tamworth and grew up pretty fast, chasing us kids around who were already 10 to 14 years older than her. For me, it was like watching this newborn enter our family home for the first time. I remember coming home from school and hear his mum sitting on the lounge with her breast out, feeding this baby. I remember being so shy I did not want to enter the lounge room while mum had that thing out. But finally, she convinced me to sit down beside her and told me this is how babies start life feeding and there is nothing to be worried about. I was totally fine after that. After all, The new baby's sister I'd been telling all the teachers about had finally arrived. In what seemed like the blink of an eye, Veronique was a ballet dancer, spinning and twirling around the house to any song that came out of our tape decks. Then she discovered Kiss. Not the action, but the band, who she rightly renamed Bieber. Well, here we go. Any chance to play some music that wasn't Engelbert Humperdinck or Shirley Bassey? We made microphone stands, cardboard cutouts, and cutout ice cream container lids as Kiss masks. And watch out Sunday afternoons if Molly Meldrum was introducing any new hits by this new band called Bieber. We were kind of allowed to turn the telly up a bit, purely for entertainment purposes. Little did we know, but Veronique was preparing us for this outgoing, laughing, this outgoing, talkative, colourful, talkative, loud, talkative, boisterous, talkative, funny, talkative, laughing the loudest at her own jokes person, who Veronique would become to be. Veronique's natural ability to light up a room with her huge teethy smile and her loud barky laugh, or just taking the piss out of someone to change the mood in the room, came so naturally to her. She was always my first port of call whenever I holidayed on the sunny coast, by getting me into the spirit of Queenslander so I could relax and unwind for a couple of weeks of downtime. Both Queensland and New South Wales got to share Veronique as a teenager. Her early teenage years were spent on the beaches of Queensland, attending laid-back Caloundra High School. Queensland is where she developed her passion for music festivals, and her love for the big day out was legendary. She threw mythical Australia Day parties that were talked about for months. Shortly before her 17th birthday, Veronique returned to Tamworth, completing years 11 and 12 at Oxley High School. It was her friendship with Annabelle and their shared diary that would start topics of conversation when Veronique was feeling nostalgic and wanted to reminisce. It was throughout this time that Veronique developed her deep fascination of astrology. Her life and everyone she touched was influenced by what your star sign was. She could tell if you were going to be friends or by this one answer. And she was always right. There's an alien in the attic. Before I knew it, Veronique was multiplying. By the end of her pregnancy, Veronique was riding a bike to hurry up the next process. Nisha Beau burst onto the scene early one morning, and Veronique checked herself out of hospital that afternoon. My party-hardy little sister was out of action. No more sitting up till late drinking and talking crap. Now it was getting up early and taking Nisha to the beach, but not swimming because Veronique hated the water. Mikkel and Veronique settled into parenthood, with Mikkel doing the blokey thing, and Veronique, being Veronique, took the role with a vengeance. A bit like Captain Marvel, but with more superpowers. Protecting her family from bad drivers by driving even badder. Then letting the bad drivers know they were the bad driver. Now, this little gremlin, Nisha, was growing up fast. Before I knew it, we were being treated with fairy bread and copious amounts of what was called tea by our new host, followed by endless episodes of SpongeBob SquarePants playing in the background. Veronique loved motherhood. Nisha talks about her magnificent roasts, her unparalleled potato bake, and her endless desire for minestrone soup. Veronique's ability to turn a perfectly healthy paycheck into clothing was outstanding. She called it her passion for fashion, and it's nobody's business. She could create a show-stopping outfit from anything, always saying, it's all in the accessories. She always looked good. Where do I even begin to list her many and varied accomplishments? Bringing her beautiful daughter, Nisha, into the world was one of her proudest moments. Nisha travelled the career journey with Veronique every step of the way, a very strong and capable mother and daughter team. Whilst raising Nisha, Veronique followed a lifelong yearning of becoming a hairdresser, enthusiastically completing her apprenticeship in record time. Her artistic flair resulted in her many friends and clientele returning time after time to enjoy her good humour, great storytelling, and also to get their hair done. Her ability to cut, colour and style whilst holding an animated conversation made you feel just that little bit better. Spending more time like this with her will be greatly missed. Veronique's love of reading and wanting to share her knowledge resulted in her resetting her goals and deciding to pursue a career in teaching. A quantum leap from hairdressing to teaching, however, never daunted. Veronique embarked on this journey, juggling motherhood, hairdressing, and studying. A passion for information grew beyond wanting to teach for Veronique and led her toward a career of law. She recently completed the first two semesters of her pre-law degree, achieving distinctions. This was reflective of her. Leave no stone unturned and all options considered. Approach. The legal field had no idea of the passion Veronique would have brought to achieving justice had she been given the opportunity. The Veronique we loved. For us as a family, we loved the light that shone from Veronique. She could make you laugh until you cried, especially when it came to entertaining her nieces and nephews with her rendition of the Lollipop Guild by the Munchkins from The Wizard of Oz. Smile until your cheeks hurt and love beyond a depth of feeling you believed capable. You're right, mate. Veronique has now taken her final journey home and will forever be tenderly remembered by her family and friends who loved her unconditionally.
Thank you, Peter, very much for sharing all of that, how hard it is for you to stand here and share such wonderful memories when your heart is aching. We're now going to take a stroll down memory lane and we're going to revisit some beautiful memories.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
I welcome Jess and Warren. I'm very sorry that that plane was late, but we're glad you're here now. We'll have just a few moments of peaceful reflection for each of you to recall your own personal memories of Veronique, and for those that wish to, you may pray at this time. I would now like to invite the family first and then anyone else who would like to come forward, take one of these beautiful favourite flowers, as flowers of Veronique's, and as you place it on her casket, please take a moment to say a final goodbye.
Thank you.
Could I please ask everyone, where possible, to stand for the committal and blessing? Feel no guilt in laughter, she knows how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that she's not here to share. You cannot grieve forever, she would not want you to. She'd hope that you would carry on the way you always do. So talk about the good times and the ways you showed you cared, the days you spent together, all the happiness you shared. Let the memories surround you. A word someone may say will suddenly recapture a time, an hour, a day that brings her back as clearly as though she were still here and fills you with the feelings that she is always near. For if you keep those memories, you will never be apart, and she will live forever, locked safe within your heart. Take care, Veronique. Until we meet again, may you rest in peace. But I please ask you all now to join in the Lord's Prayer. You'll find the words inside the order of service. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for just a few more moments. We have been remembering with love and gratitude a life that was important and honouring life itself. I sincerely hope that in time you can all be comforted to some degree by this important last act of love and respect that you've shed in here today. Veronique's life has been like a tapestry into which you all are woven to some extent. It is made up of many threads of memories, which no matter how time passes will always remain somewhere in your hearts, safely stored to be accessed when you need them. The greatest testimony to her memory is to make the most of your own lives now. Accept each day as a precious gift. Take time to unwrap every day and live those days to their fullest. Veronique's family, thank you sincerely for your presence here today, your prayers and your support. Are greatly appreciated. Veronique's family would like to invite you to join with them to share some light refreshments at the West Tamworth Sports and Bowling Club in Belmore Street, West Tamworth, where you can continue to share your memories of Veronique. Thank you all very much.
the touch of your hand will let me know. You take me in and let me go. If not for love, why would we meet? How is it done? Two into one, so easily lifted up by angels, higher than. Lifted up by